What's going on, world? This is Grandmaster Facts, and this is another Partynerdz exclusive. So now, premiering at New York Comic Con, the Partynerdz took part in a two-hour panel and pilot footage of the new HBO series, The Watchmen, starring Regina King and Jeremy Irons. But first, if you could hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, we will keep you up to date on any exclusive content by myself, Grandmaster Facts, and the Partynerdz. Now first, let me give you a little bit of history. Alan Moore's masterpiece, The Watchmen, was released in September of 1986, centering around being one of the first comics that reflect anxieties and deconstruction of satirization of the superhero concept. Watchmen took current history and flipped it on its head, with heroes entering the 1940s and the 60s where they helped win the Vietnam War and had such paradigm-changing history points like the break-in at Watergate never even taken place. But with the United States on the brink of a third world war with the Soviet Union, mass vigilantes had been banned and outlawed, and some have either retired or are working for the government. It isn't until a murder of one of their own pulls them out of the shadows. These characters were originally led by Silk Spectre, Owlman, Ozymandias, the Comedian, and the infamous Dr. Manhattan, all original characters. Watchmen has even received much respected acclaim by comic fans and the mainstream, even recognized in Time Magazine's list of the 100 best novels, and some say it was the factual moment when comic books turned into graphic novels and, for a better sense of the phrase, grew up. And now, just 10 years ago, we received our first glimpse of the Zack Snyder live adaptation of the DC Vertigo imprint in 2009. Raw and very interpreting for its time, seeing characters that were freshly human with no codes or moral standards for us to connect with. For almost 20 years from the debut of the graphic novel, it laid stranded in development hell, even being deemed unfilmable. But taking a chance on a director in Zack Snyder, who just 2 years prior adapted Frank Miller's comic book graphic novel 300 into a box office smash, and in the end it pulled in a phenomenal $185 million for Watchmen, for an R-rated comic book movie to do this in that time of frame, in the middle of DC and Marvel just about to kick off their universe, it was something that is a sight to see. That a rated R comic book movie could do this much and push this much weight. So this leads to the present day, where Damon Lindelof, creator of Lost and The Great Leftovers for HBO, takes over the helms of this project of a series for HBO. Now note that this is a man who has turned down this Watchmen project twice. And it's not that he disliked the story, but he is one of the many who consider the novel of The Watchmen as a masterpiece that shouldn't be touched, especially in a TV series format. But the great Alan Moore has already given his blessing and has considered himself one of the few who have taken on doing adaptations, just as Zack Snyder did, and just as DC has doing the Before Watchmen series and prequels, and now currently with DC's Doomsday Clock. So I ask of anyone before the series debuts on October 20th, know this, that the events concluding at the end of Zack Snyder's Watchmen 10 years ago will resurface and be reintroduced to a world where Ozymandias is relishing but conflicted in a world he created currently, 7 to 10 years later. A world that banished the all-powerful Dr. Manhattan to life on Mars after murdering his friend Rorschach, leading others into solitude. The concept of masked heroes still exists, with the introduction of Regina King's character Sister Knight. Lindelof has considered even making the series one season, so that the viewer doesn't seem complacent. I hope that's not true, but it may happen. But please let us know what you think. To conclude, leading into the series, is Ozymandias the antagonist because he killed the Comedian and 3 million innocent people? Or is he the good guy because he saved the world by taking the ultimate risk? Feel free to like, comment, and subscribe to us at the Partynerdz YouTube page, and stay tuned for more developments. Partynerdz go.